Hey guys, good morning. Happy Sunday morning, and it's good to see you all. This morning, I'm just going to start off with some worship, and we're going to sing two songs. Just sing that song, Freedom, and we're going to sing that song, Jesus, Lover, My Soul. And then I'm going to get into a short message, hopefully to encourage us for the week, and then we'll be back with some more content. And so let's just sing that song, Freedom. And where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is freedom. And where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is freedom. There is peace, there is love, there is joy. It is for freedom. It is for freedom, you said. And I'm free, and I'm free, yes, I'm free, and I'm free, and I'm free. We will walk, we will walk in your freedom, walk in your liberty, and we will walk in your freedom, walk in your liberty. Yes, we will dance. We will dance in your freedom, dance in your liberty. We will dance in your freedom, dance in your liberty. Where the Spirit is, where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is freedom. And where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is peace, there is love, there is joy. It is for freedom you set us free. It is for freedom you set us free. It is for freedom you set us free. God is good. Jesus is alive. Amen. And so no matter what's going on, we have hope in God. Amen. Remember that Jesus died and he's alive today and that he loves us. And so let's sing out that song, Jesus, Lover of My Soul. We praise God this morning.
Jesus, Lover of My Soul. Jesus, and I will never let you go. Taken me from the miry clay. You set my feet upon the rock. Now I know that I love you and I need you. And you're my only hope. I'll never let you go. taken me from my reclaim. You set my feet upon the rock. Now I know that I love you and I need you. You're my only hope. I'll never let you go.
Amen. Praise the Lord today. Amen. I want to get into the Word of God, but before we get into the Word of God, amen, remember that you can give, and so in light of that, Donald Trump's just signed a $2 trillion stimulus, and what's incredible about that is that I read an article, and what it stated was that there's already some companies who are stating to their employees that if you get the stimulus and you get some money, then they're going to take that out of your paycheck. I thought to myself, isn't that how it is? People always trying to get what they can all the time. But you know, the Bible teaches us as Christians something different. And that is that we are to give. We're to become like God. We're to be givers. We're to change, because before we come to Christ, it's all about receive, 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 take, get what I can. But when we get saved, then there's something that has to change in us to where we want to give. And there's many ways to give, but one of the main ways is that we give to our local church. We give to our church, and we serve in that capacity because the church has bills. And it has rent, and it has electricity, just like you would in your own home. And so I want to encourage you in that, especially members of our church. You know who you are. You know what you can give. You can Zelle. Use the Zelle app. thedoorchurchupland@gmail.com. thedoorchurchupland@gmail.com. There'll be a note below. And then also, if you know who I am, if you feel more comfortable just by letting me know and calling me, that'll be fine as well. But to give an offering, to take an offering, we're still going to have to make things work. And so I know things are tight, things are hard, but you know what? Some can do more than others, but everyone can do something. And so I want to encourage you in that, in giving. And so now I'm ready to talk to you about what's been on my heart, especially this week. Last week I talked about the armor of God and taking it up again, because we tend to backslide, we tend to neglect. And so this morning I just want to just give a real quick encouragement, because in verse 16 of Ephesians chapter 6, verse 16, it says this. It says, above all, and that's the reason why I wanted to talk about this, because above all, that means first and foremost, everything else is secondary. This is the first thing that we need to do. Above all, this is the most important. So there's important things in your spiritual life that are very important, and then there are things that are not so as important. Jesus being the most important thing. Understanding the symbols in the book of Revelation, okay, well, you know, we might be able to get away with that, but we're not going to get away without knowing who Jesus is. So there's important things, and this is what he's saying, above all, take the shield of faith, which you will be able to quench all the fiery darts of the wicked one. Take up the shield of faith. And so he's still in that armor. He's talking about warfare. And we talked about that last time, that it's a fight. It's a fight to live for God. It's a fight to live for Jesus. And there's no question about it. This whole book is filled with war. It's filled with fight. And so that teaches us something as Christians, that, you know what, it's a fight. And in a fight, you know what, you win some and you lose some. Sometimes, you know, you lose. You lose. Life is not this walk in the park. You know, if you're like me, when I first got saved, when I first became a Christian, I thought that because I'm living for God and because I'm giving and I'm serving, that I should be in this God bubble, that I should be totally protected and nothing wrong should happen to me. You know, God should protect me and I should face no adversity. But when you read your Bible, you learn something different. And God teaches us. And most importantly, he tries to prepare us, because it's not what happens that determines our future. It's what we do about it. It's what we do about it. It's what you do about it. It's not the circumstances that surround you. It's what you're doing about it. It's not what you're going through. It's how you're handling it. It's the kind of attitude that you keep. It's the way that you press through it. That's going to be the difference maker for you in the long run. And so what he's saying for us today is take up the shield of faith. Be ready to do combat. Be ready to fight. Be ready to be on guard. Take it up. Guard yourself. Protect yourself. Protect your mind. The fiery darts of the wicked one that go into your heart and into your mind. It could be temptations that come. Thoughts of temptations. Thoughts of lust. Thoughts of greed. Thoughts of desire that you know that go against your Christian conduct. Thoughts of anger. Thoughts of hatred. All those things that go contrary to what God teaches us that should be in our spirit. It says to walk in the spirit. Walk in the fruits of the spirit. What kind of fruit do you have? Let the fruit of the spirit show in your life. Love, joy, peace, kindness, regardless of the circumstance. So take up the shield of faith so that you may do battle. But what kind of faith? Because James tells us that, well, let me just say that. See, some people think, or maybe this is you, you think that if you make a mental ascension or if you say, well, you know, I believe that Jesus died for me and that he rose from the dead, then I'm okay. Well, the Bible, James teaches us that even demons believe. Even demons believe and they tremble. So that's crazy because they believe and they tremble, but they're not saved and they're not going to get saved. That could be true for a lot of people. Well, I believe, but that's not the kind of faith that he's talking about in this text, the shield of faith. It's impossible because the demons believe with that kind of faith, but yet they're not saved. So it's something different. It's something more. It's something beyond just a mental ascension. And it goes beyond just Bible knowledge. The Pharisees in the Bible were masters of the Word of God of the Old Testament. They understood it. They memorized it. One commentator said that most of them can memorize the first five books of the Bible. Most of us are struggling just to memorize five verses. But yet, when Jesus came on the scene, they didn't recognize him. What does that teach us about, you know, filling our head with Bible knowledge? It's good. Read your Bible. Study your Bible. But listen, let it get into the heart. Because the heart's the real thing. It's about the heart. It's about what comes out of our heart. We can know, but we're not going to live it if it's not in our heart. So it's more than Bible knowledge, this shield of faith. This shield of faith is faith that justifies. Faith that justifies. The Bible teaches us as Christians that we are justified by faith. We are saved through grace. By faith. It's the faith that justifies. Now, the faith that justifies says this. The faith that gets justification says, I am believing active. I am believing actively on Jesus for my salvation because he died and he shed his blood for me. And he's alive today. That I can be justified. Not that I believed years ago or last week, last month. No, that I'm believing today. Today, the Bible teaches us about today. In our text, it says that you may be able to stand in the evil day. Listen, every day has all of its evils. There's evil. We can find evil in every day. Every day there's evil. In your life, every day, there's evil trying to get into you. There's evil all around you. There's evil all the world that's around us. Every day, so that we can stand. It's the faith that justifies. The shield of faith that justifies, because the shield of faith that justifies is an active faith. It's a faith that's taking action. It's a faith that's fighting. It's a faith that's praying. It's a faith that's believing. It's a faith that's going beyond just, well, I'm showing up to church, but the rest of the week I'm living how I want or whatever, you know, I'm doing. I'm playing games with God. No, God knows. That's not the kind of faith. That's the shield of faith. And that's why the fiery darts are not quenched. That's why you fall into temptation. That's why you fall into the trap of your attitudes and your spirit is just not right. It's not there. And people know. But you know what? God knows too. take up the shield of faith. And the reason why I say this is because right now there's a lot going on. It's tough. Personally, you know what, just real talk, you know, I'm going through some hard times myself. I'm having an adjustment, having a change. And you know what, it's difficult. But the circumstances that surround me do not dictate who I'm going to be. Do not dictate what I'm going to do, what kind of attitude I'm going to have. You know what? I'm still going to put God first. How about you? You're still going to put God first? Or do you allow it to be an excuse? Well, Pastor, you know, I've been having a hard time, so. No. Listen, either you're going to put God first or you're not. Either you're going to take up the shield of faith or you're not. Come on, you got to be real. You got to be honest with God. And that's why I could do this. You know what? It doesn't matter where I am. It doesn't matter what I'm going to do. My calling is to preach. I don't have to be a pastor to preach and to witness. I don't need a title. It's like the Apostle Paul says, woe is me if I don't preach. Woe is me. I feel like I'm wrong. I feel like something's going wrong with me if I don't say something about God and tell people about Jesus. And so I'm telling you again today to get up and fight. Take up the shield of faith. You need to remember every day. You need to thank God every day for the blood. Oh, that blood, the blood that was shed for you and that was shed for me on Calvary's tree. Come on, what does it say for us to do? It says to keep our eyes on Jesus. Why? Because he's the rock. He's the foundation. He's solid. He doesn't move. He doesn't change. Right now, our world's being shaken. All the institutions are shaken. Maybe your job has been shaken. You know, your retirement from 401k, it's all being shaken. But you know what stands true is Jesus, the rock. He's the rock. And what does he tell us? He says, foolish is the man who builds his life on the sand. Why? Because he's building his life on materialism. He's building his life on even just wisdom and knowledge. No, Jesus said, the wise man builds on the rock. And when the storm comes, there's a storm right now. When the storm comes, he's able to stand. He's able to, his house, when the winds beat on it, he's able to stand. He's able to stand firm. And that's where I want to be. I want to be someone who stands the test of time. Who stands the test of time, because faith, if it's not justified faith, then it doesn't stand the test of time. Jesus tells us about the word that goes on to, it's the seed, and it gets scattered, and some of it goes on to the stony ground. It goes onto the stony ground, and before it can bear any fruit, the birds of the air come and pick it up and take it away. That's how some people's faith is, isn't it? As soon as they hear the word of God, as soon as it goes into their heart, some worry or something else comes and takes it away, some other motivation, some distraction. They know it's true. They know it's right for them. And then there's the others, the seed, it goes in, but then it doesn't grow a root. And so because it's not rooted, because it's not grounded, when the sun comes up, when it gets hot, when it gets tested, it fails. That's not faith that justifies. That's not going to be the shield of faith. Those are the fiery darts, the cares of this world, the worries that we're battling. The shield of faith. And so, I just want to share a quick message with you with all my heart. Listen, it's tough. It's hard, but listen, come on. You can hold on to God. Above all else, hold on to Jesus. Maybe your heart's not even right today. Even some of the things, you know you're not carrying the shield of faith. There's all kinds of darts, fiery darts that are getting through. Mind battles and so many different things that are going on in your own life. Listen, let it be. Let the outside be what it is. But you can control you. You can control your emotions. You can take up your shield of faith. And that's why I want to encourage you today. Come on, let's take up the shield. Let's remember what he did for us on the cross. Let's go back to that place to where we first believed and do those first works, just like Jesus writes to the Ephesian church in the book of Revelation. That's what he tells them. He said, I want you to go back to the beginning. I want you to go back to your first love. I want you to go back. Maybe that's where you are this morning. you're out there, you're hearing it, maybe you're backslidden. And, you know, for whatever reason, you're just listening to this. Listen, I want to tell you, go back to the beginning. Go back to when you first believed. Go back to where your heart was on fire. Where your heart was on fire. Not the fiery darts were coming and taking your fire, but your heart was on fire for God. Come on. What have you got to lose? It's 2020. I had a feeling in the beginning of this year that something crazy was going to go on. And it's happening. It's happening. It's happening. Come on. These are the last of the last days. Now's not the time to play God. Play games. Let's get serious about the most serious thing on this side of heaven. Our salvation. Get serious about Jesus. Maybe you have, you know what, you're maybe just because of this thing that's going on in the world, you've kind of drifted. No, no, you need to get back on. Reach out to somebody. Call somebody. Let them give you faith. And so before that, I want to go, but I want to just pray with you. Maybe you're out there and you have a prayer request. You can send it in to our church. Go to our church website, and then you'll be able to submit a prayer request, and we'll pray for you. I'll pray for you personally. Or, you know, maybe you're just, anyways, I just want to pray and just believe God with you. If you're listening to me and maybe, you know what, God spoke to you right now, you'd go and pray somewhere. And this is a little informal for me, obviously, but I still want to say something and encourage and strengthen somehow, some way. Very soon we'll be able to do our church services, but send in a prayer request. And before we go, I want to pray with you. And so I'm just going to bow my head and I'm going to pray. Father God, I thank you for this morning. Jesus, I rejoice in your goodness and grace and your salvation. God, I pray, God, for the church in this time. God, I pray, God, that we would come out stronger, God, than when we went in. God, that you would help us. God, I pray, God, for your people, God, that there would be a conviction put upon their hearts, God. A conviction, God, to turn on you stronger in prayer, God, stronger in their personal devotion to you. And even in this time, God, I come to you, God, with a humble heart, God, asking, God, for grace to be given. God, I pray for our nation. God, we need a miracle. God, you'd stop this epidemic, God. You'd move in your way, God. You'd turn it to your glory, God. And even now, God, we're asking for revival, God, a breakthrough, God, your spirit coming down. Lord, I thank you for the people, God, and everyone that heard this message. I pray it bears fruit in their hearts, God, in the days and weeks to come. I give you thanks and I give you praise in Jesus' name. Amen. Tune in for the next message. God bless you.